Hello, ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, Martians and aliens. We're not speciesists on this channel. Everybody's welcome. My name's Alan, and welcome to Mars, the second Genesis. Well, guys, we've got a cracker for you today. This one was captured by the Perseverance rover on Sol 78 and was taken with the left and the right Z mast cam. Okay, so let's jump into Photoshop and I'll show you and the half-wits at NASA how to properly colour balance an image. Press Ctrl M. And this will bring up the curves palette. And what you do is go into options. And it'll take a wee minute. The first time you go in, these will not be the settings. And what you want to do is click on Fine Dark and Light Colours, Snap Neutral Midtones, and Save as Defaults, and click OK. Now I'm going to come out of that, and now that's saved as defaults, we'll press the Ctrl and M key once again, and click on our options, and it'll take a wee bit of time. And there we have a colour balanced image. And these are the defaults that will now colour balance your image from now on. You don't need to keep clicking on these to get your image colour balanced. All you do is just click on options, takes a wee minute, and it'll colour balance your image, and just OK it. And that's you, that's a colour balance. Wasn't that so easy, NASA? Why can't you bloody well do that? But no, you've got to put this horrible orange colour cast on it. I wonder why you do that. Is it maybe to obfuscate what's in the image? Is it maybe to hide the fact that you've bloody blown out a lot of the whites to hide the detail? I wonder. Idiots. Anyway, I get a bit upset about these sort of things sometimes. This is a zoomed in version showing our anomaly in the centre of the image. Not big enough for you? Okay, let's zoom in a bit more, shall we? And here we have the enhanced version. As you can see, we've got two main parts here, the top piece and the bottom piece. So let's zoom in a wee bit to have a closer look at the top piece. We have the front end, which is pointed, and then we have this thing that looks like a wing. And as we move towards the back, we have this hole, and inside we see some details. And going towards the back, we have this, which looks like a tail. Now at first I thought this was an aircraft, but I don't think so. Now let's take a wee look here at this back piece. Now, this piece seems to be resting on this here. And we can clearly see it's raised above the bottom piece. So this whole piece from here to the back is supported by this so-called sand. So we can clearly see this is not sand. You can clearly see this is a hard edge. So there's something below this, and we can see the shape here. We'll come back to that a wee bit later on. Let's take a close look at the bottom. Now we've got this piece here, which looks as if it's behind our anomaly. And we have this, we get some detail at the front here, could be some carvings or hieroglyphs. And we can see it seems to be split in the centre there. If we look here, and look here, and look here, it's almost as if this has been bricks. So if we look at this, it seems to be parallel, following the contours right to the back, and we have some sort of detail here. And again, we may have some carvings or hieroglyphs. Now, I'd like to point something out about all this pattern. This is something NASA puts over all the images. And I believe it's an attempt to obfuscate the image so we can't see what's there. If you look down the bottom here, you can see some lines in the sand. NASA has bump mapped this colour and this pattern to what was there. So the shadows we're seeing is the shadows of the original image that was there. And our final image is this high contrast enhanced image of the surrounding area that the anomaly is located in. I'll just zoom in a bit, and I'll start from the left and I'll pan to the right. And we'll look at it a wee bit more in detail. But I'd like you to pay close attention to the sand. Okay, so let's do a bit of inventory. We seem to have some sort of plinth here. Obviously, this could be a sculpture or whatever it is. The plinth seems to be what the anomaly is resting on. Now, if we look here, we can see some detail joining these pieces of so-called rock. And if we look here, we can see, I'll zoom in a bit, I'll let you see, I'll pan through this. Ignore all this garbage, see all this pattern, ignore that. What we're looking at is the dominant shadows and highlights. And if you notice here this curve, you can see it's almost as if the sand's covering it, but I believe this sand isn't actually there. And we see this piece here. And look at this. This here is part of that. So this, whatever it is resting on this. And it comes down and along. You can clearly see that. So all this is together. They are not separate anomalies, and they're certainly not separate rocks. We can see a bit of carving here, all down the side. And we can clearly see that this bit here is artificial. If we look at this here, you know, you're just seeing, they're showing you wee bits that you think is just rocks. But when you actually look at the overall enhanced image here, you can clearly see that that's one piece. And this piece at the back looks quite interesting as well. If you look, it comes up. You see how they're disguising the anomalies? I mean, all this is just pure garbage, which has been overlaid. And because of the enhancement process, it's brought it out. So you can see clearly what they've overlaid. But if you look at the dominant shadows and highlights here, it comes up. And this was the piece. The left had made it look like a rock, but you can clearly see this is all the one thing, and it comes up, and it's parallel, and it comes up, attaches to this piece here. And again, the white pieces here, that's the bits they've shown, but when you look at it, you can see how they've disguised it. And you can clearly see this is not rocks. And this here, we've got this, whatever this is. You can see the outline of it coming down. It's some sort of mechanical thing. I'll take a wee inventory of this side. You can see this here coming along. And this joins onto this. And this joins onto that. And you see all this. And you can see at the back there what they've tried to make as sand dunes. And you can see that's not sand dunes. And we'll look at this bottom piece here. And you can see all these bits here is what they left. But if you look, they're all connected. Now, at a distance, it does look like sand, but when you zoom in, you can see it's not sand, and you can see what's below. I would say these anomalies are smooth, they don't have this texture on it. The most interesting part I find is this piece here, the way this comes up. And it shows quite a bit of detail. I'll just zoom in a bit and I'll pan across. I mean, it is pretty clever how they've done it. But when you look at it, you can see these are not individual anomalies. It's basically, they've took the original image, they've overlaid this garbage in it, they've ghosted out most of what was in the original image, and they've left some individual parts, and then made them look like rocks. So, as always guys, you can let me know in the comments what you think. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.